Warning. The language used on The Real Rush may be offensive to some viewers. Don't say I didn't fucking warn you.
Ooh, Toshiro. Toshiro. Toshiro-san. We're going to go see Godzilla Minus One.
So Godzilla Minus One plus dub plus a lot of weed. Fucking, it's about to be awesome, man. I really hope that they got a goddamn, what you call it? They got a poster for this shit out here? I want to see a poster. What the fuck is this?
Is this a remake of fucking Mean Girls? Are you fucking kidding me?
Didn't the first one come out in like, I don't know, 2004-ish? Maybe 2005? That's not even 20 years. I haven't seen it. I've never seen the original. Yes, I've never fucking seen the original fucking Mean Girls. I get shit for it all the time. For being a fucking movie buff and having never seen Mean Girls. But to be quite honest with you, even having not seen it yet, just from everything that you motherfuckers keep saying about it, it sounds overrated. Not saying that it's not good, and not saying that I'm not gonna watch it at some point, but Jesus Christ, like, pump your fucking brakes. A lot of the same motherfuckers have never seen, like, The Godfather or some shit. I guess I gotta go pump this shit before I go see a fucking remake. Anywho, let's go see if we can find a goddamn Godzilla. Fuck, you got a goddamn Mean Girls poster, you ain't got no motherfucking Godzilla poster. Got a nigga ranting.
Fucking Mean Girls fucking musical fucking remake. Get the fuck out of here.
What the hell are you looking at, kid?
You're at your best when you're smoking the weed, 'cause the weed is all you really need. Give me the stuff. Give me the flower. Yeah. Woo!
Who was the first Time Magazine Person of the Year in 1927? That would be none other than Chucky Lindy. Charles Lindbergh, yo. So let's take a moment and think about progress. We've gone from Charles Lindbergh to Taylor Swift. Don't cheer for that!
No!
You mean to tell me we didn't cure anything this year? We didn't prevent or, like, not stop any war from happening? Nobody went into outer space that wasn't a billionaire douchebag? We got Taylor Swift.
Hi, I'm Johnny Dubville. I'm high as fuck, and I'm about to go see this joint.
Three and a half hours later and some change. Them motherfuckers are like, it's like 2:30 in the morning, y'all got to get the fuck out the theater. Couldn't even let me use the bathroom without cutting the goddamn lights off. So there you go, your mad movie professor right here, literally riding fucking theaters until the wheels fall off, or in this case, until the lights cut out. How was Avatar? How was Avatar? Let's get right to it.
What's up, y'all? It's a mad movie professor outside of the legendary AMC Potomac Mills. After just seeing Barbie, this was the best pink and blue shit that I could find. I just saw Barbie in Dolby Cinema with a couple of my peoples. My edibles kicked in about 45-ish minutes ago. Let's bug the fuck out. It's great on edibles. That shit was bananas before the edibles kicked in. It was even more bananas after the edibles fucking kicked in. I never really played with Barbies as a kid. I did a little bit. There's no wacky tobacco in this. There's a lot of crazy shit going on right now. Wow. Just oddball, but yet I did like its message about self-discovery. I wouldn't make it so much a man versus woman issue. Just self-discovery, and if anything, it's like alphas versus everybody. So that's my take on Barbie. I'm about to go in here and see Oppenheimer.
The fuck is this?
Anyone but you, huh? Oh yeah. I just can't wait to fucking stand in line to go see this shit. Yeah.
Who's gonna go see this movie? Anyone but me. Fuck. Motherfuckers. Yes. Now we're fucking talking, man.
Here we go, baby. This is what I'm talking about. Yes. Godzilla Minus One. This is what the fuck we are about to go see. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right, so I saw Shin Godzilla up in the theater back when that dropped back in 2K16. Same as this one. Had no idea that it was coming, so it was not on my radar. Saw Shin Godzilla. That was one of my top 10 movies of 2K16, if I recall correctly, and I do believe I'm recalling quite correctly here. This is about to be fucking epic, y'all. Let's go get our fucking ticket, and I'm gonna be getting it. Yeah. Theater number 8. Number 8. Let's go see some Godzilla Minus One. Oh yes, I forgot about the long epic walk down the theater hallway once you're actually in the theater, yes.
When you gonna learn not to fuck with me? I'm from Chinatown, baby.
I thought that shit said the boy and the heroin. I mean, it is Woodbridge.
So no one told you life was gonna be this way. Your job's a joke, you're broke. Matthew Perry is the OA.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
Aziz! Light! Alright, y'all, it's about 12:45, not minus one, 12:45, we just got out this bad motherfucker right here a couple of moments ago, and yes, it is a bad motherfucker. Can you see me? Let the light balance out. There we go, Godzilla Minus One, baby. Yeah, dog, it was the bomb. Yeah, this movie had... It's got, see, that's one thing that the American, like, Hollywood movies can't just, like, seem to nail with their Godzilla, like, remakes and whatnot and reboots or whatnot. They can't quite capture the human side of things like the original Japanese Toei fucking Godzilla movies like this bad motherfucker does, man. So yeah, it's got the human side, it's got plenty of heart, emotion, the score in it is mwah, I love that. I think that might get a little bit of attention at the, it should get like some attention at this year's Oscars, and yes, I did say Oscars. I would go on to say that, alright, I like the way this joint was filmed, especially given like the World War II type, the World War II, post-World War II scenario, if you will. It had elements of it that I kind of saw. It had elements like Jaws, like meets Independence Day and a little bit of Dunkirk, like sprinkled on it. And just, whoo, that was a fine one, baby. Fuck minus one, plus one, plus one, plus one, plus one, Godzilla minus one. Just like Shin Godzilla, I think this might have to be one of the best movies of the year thus far, 2K23. I got a lot of shit to catch up on, but goddamn, come see Godzilla Minus One. Godzilla Minus One, goddamn. All right, so there's my review of that shit. There you go. I'm gonna go get me some Burger King or some shit.
I'm sorry. I'm sitting here still in the fucking Burger King drive-thru listening to Cottonmouth King's fucking 420. And yeah, that shit did not deceive you, my peoples. That shit says Beyond Hello Cannabis Dispensary. See, original part of the video. I just had a third good and half-baked moment. That's fucking beautiful shit, man. Never in my lifetime would I thought I'd see that shit, so thank you, Governor Northam. That makes up for the blackface. Awesome, motherfucker! Well, I guess since you wanted the blackface so bad, I guess I can say awesome, nigga.
Hola, 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 hola. Shit, I'm high. Fuck it. Y'all know that, because if you're watching Real Russian, you already know that. Hey, I just got done watching both, fuck did I just go say? The Blackening and The Flash in honor of Juneteenth. Fuck it, we'll do that again.
Y'all, 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 y'all.
It's your boy. It's after Juneteenth. Look at the fucking parking lot. Look at the parking lot. Once again, the last motherfucker rolling at the movie theater till the motherfucking wheels fall off. It's about 1:45 in the morning. I just got finished watching The Blackening and The Flash. We done seen these two movies high as hell. Two great ass ways to spend a motherfucking Juneteenth. I even got pictures for both them motherfuckers. And The Blackening, that was just an awesome ass experience to have with my fellow brothers and sisters up in the movie theater for finally making, you know, being the first, you know, major film release of a fucking movie to honor the holiday of Juneteenth. Fuck yeah, that's what the fuck I was trying to say. Yeah, weed's wearing off. Believe it or not. So have fun, y'all. Love J-Dub, and I'ma go do some more motherfucking donuts. Peace out. Ciao. It's the claw. It's the claw. It's the claw. And as we all know, nothing can stop the claw. What? Y'all thought I wasn't going. Y'all thought I was going to end the year without coming to see not what is being called one of the best movies of the year, and not only to come see a movie about pro wrestling, but a long-awaited story of the legendary Von Erich family. I mean, come on, man, the lineup's right, the director's right, the studio's right, my THC levels are right. This is tonight's main event tonight. Yes, cannot wait for this. Yes, yes, yes. Ooh, check this out, y'all. The Bob Marley movie got its own stand-up.
You must win it with Rasta. You can't win no other way, because if you win other way, you're gonna fight again or something like that. I don't know.
Here we go, y'all. It's time for the claw. It's time for the claw. It's time for the claw.
Yep. It's after Oppenheimer. The parking lot is even more empty, as it is almost 2:00 in the morning, if not 2:00 in the fucking morning right now. So I've been, it's been an 8-hour journey for two movies. Remember how I said during my review or rant, whatever you want to call it, of Barbie here a little bit ago, that the edibles had kicked in? Yeah, that was a false statement. The motherfuckers didn't really kick in until right before fucking Oppenheimer, like when they peaked. And it was during a fucking trailer of the new Exorcist joint, like the Exorcist Believer or some shit like that, man. Yeah, that did not put me in a good place, but Oppenheimer, thank God that came right after. And there were only like four trailers, either that or I walked in late. I might have walked in late. I don't understand how the fuck that happened, but it happened. Oh well, if it did. Oppenheimer. So it's 3 hours? It didn't feel like it. It didn't feel like no fucking 3 hours. People have been saying that's this year's first bona fide Best Picture contender, I might go as far to say that it is possibly, this year's Best Picture. So far, of course, but granted, that would make it this year's Best Picture. We're talking nominations, of course, because we got a long season to go. Best Picture, Best Editing. I'm going to go ahead and say Best Supporting Actor for my man RDJ, Robert Downey Jr. Maybe something for Best Actor for Cillian Murphy. Possibly one for Best Actress for Emily Blunt. I could see a nod going to the screenwriting. And of course, well, music. Oh, the music score was pretty dope. The audio editing, of course, was fucking on. Oh, the cinematography. Yes. Just an all-around good fucking movie. And I'm glad that I main evented Barbenheimer day, night, whatever the fuck, in the way that it was spelled, Barbenheimer. We did Barbie first, then we did Oppenheimer. So which one of the two would I say is the better of the two? Without a shadow of a doubt, Oppenheimer. Oppenheimer is the champ of the fucking Barbenheimer weekend. I said that joint was gonna be loud. That joint was loud. Oppenheimer is the undisputed Real Rush Barbenheimer champion.
This movie, y'all. This movie, y'all. It's about 1:30 in the morning. I just got out of this joint. If my shit is a little bit redder and puffier than it was going into it, it's because it ain't just because of the strawberry runs and snowstorm blend that I put together to go into this motherfucker. It's because this movie was on point, man. I could do a hand clap with a hand holding the camera. There we go, bro. What did my boy Nick Cage say in Face Off as Cast of Troy? Bravo, bravo, bra, fucking, vo, bravo. Bravo, yo. The acting was superb in this joint. And being a pro wrestling fan, I've been fiending for a movie set in the sportatorium era or in the sportatorium itself for many, many years. We finally get that. The production design is off the chain in this movie. The visual effects to kind of give it that late 70s, early 80s, watching pro wrestling on broadcast, maybe cable TV if you were lucky enough to have that kind of shit. Like, it had that kind of finesse, that grain to the film itself. It's gonna be really interesting to see where this lands in the nominees for. It's getting Oscar attention. It's getting Oscar attention. If you are a pro wrestling fan, much like the wrestler, you got to see this joint, man. And even if you ain't, then hey, maybe you need it. Maybe just like the wrestler, it opens some people's eyes into the world of, you know, how, you know, pro wrestling really was behind the scenes and everything back then. Then I still say that this is a must-see regardless. Come check out the art, yo. I didn't know that my boy MJF, who's defending the AEW title later on tonight at World's End against Samoa Joe, was an executive producer for this joint. So you could tell that the heart and the passion was going into this movie, both on camera and behind the scenes, yo.
Speaking of MJF, the Mad Movie champ here, need to talk about the wrestling choreography in the Iron Claw. It was choreographed by none other than the legendary Chavo Guerrero, both him and MJF showing up in cameos at certain points in the movie. Look for the Easter egg, says the champ. Could have gotten a better guy to play Ric Flair. Shit, let me play Ric Flair.
So I'm not saying this just as a pro wrestling fan. I'm not saying this as a pro wrestling, just as a pro wrestling fan at all. I'm saying that this movie is a must-see, regardless of if you are one or not. That is my Real Rush review on that joint. Thanks for joining us on episode 110 of the Real Rush. I told y'all I wasn't gonna go a whole year without having an episode please put out here. So don't forget to join us back here in a future time, whenever the hell I put out episode 111. Y'all.
know? So until then, enjoy your happy New Year's and everything, and his love from your mad trivia host, the one and only John Dub. We'll see you next time, y'all. Peace out.
What two pro wrestling stars teamed up in 1987? Under the name The Mega Powers.
When our hands shake together, Hulkster, the Mega Powers come together. Oh, yeah. That's right, brother. What you gonna do when 240 megawatts of the Mega Powers run wild on you? Hulk Hogan and Macho Man, Macho Man, Randy Savage, were the Mega Powers. And because of my love of the subject, if you gave me one or the other, I gave you half credit. Oh, yeah.
I didn't forget. I just didn't remember until I went to go put the footage together for this episode that I never fucking gave a review for Avatar 2. That was like a year and a week ago, and I completely forgot until I went to go look at the footage that you cut the fucking lights out on me at the theater. That's probably why I forgot to do a whole goddamn review. So here it goes right there. Here's your Avatar Way of the Water review, a year in the making. It was okay. It was okay. It was great to see that James Cameron took, you know, hundreds of millions of billions of dollars, made this visually fucking stunning film, as he should, because, you know, one wouldn't expect any less from James Cameron. However, it doesn't seem like any of that budget went into any creative thought. How the fuck you gonna wait like 12, 13 years to drop this long-awaited sequel and you're just gonna fucking rehash the first goddamn movie and somehow make it longer by adding water to the shit? Like, come on, man. And then the thing somehow gets nominated for Best Picture at last year's Oscars. Get the fuck out of here, man. Like, okay, but not that hyped, man. That is some overrated shit right there. So I will tell you this, though. I will fucking tell you this. If there's an Avatar trilogy, since there is going to be an Avatar trilogy, the third one has got to be on point. I'm not giving up hope on the goddamn trilogy just yet. Because the mid one, sometimes that could be the worst one of a trilogy. I can't think of any good examples right now because I'm a little stoned and I want some nicotine. But, not giving up hope on the trilogy. The third one has got to fire on all goddamn cylinders in the mad trivia host's mind right there. So there you go. There's my Avatar Way of the Water review. And I mean, if you're looking for some visually stunning shit that you're watching while you're stoned for about 3.5 hours, go ahead. Fucking knock yourself out, man. There you go. Avatar Way of the Water. There's my review, bitches. Finally. Happy New Year. I don't think those edibles have fucking worn off yet.